clearly that report does identify some good joint working, but also some areas of improvement. We note the fact that the council has accepted the findings of that inspection, and it will be underway to seek to address that. So taking all those things into account, our attention to the issue and on a qualified value from our conclusion, confirming that the council continues to have appropriate arrangements in place to deliver value for the money. So that leaves me the final area to pick out from the report. Just to confirm, we have received an objection to the 2015-16 accounts. That objection is asked us to consider the lawfulness of the lender option, borrower option borrowing that you have within your financial statements. We have accepted that objection. It was received within the time frame. It was received by someone who is a local government elector, and therefore we've accepted it as a valid objection. A couple of other comments I make about that. You're not the only council to receive an objection of this nature. There are other councils, both locally and nationally, receive them. We have asked the council offices for some initial information to help us to determine that objection. As I think members will be aware, our role is to get the information in from you and to consider that objection. And we will take into account all the information and potentially seek legal advice if we need to do so in terms of making that objection. We have over the last couple of weeks, since the report was issued, sought some advice, and we're satisfied that whilst the amount involved in this borrowing is large, there is nothing that prevents us from giving the opinion and the VFM conclusion on this year. We will, however, have to keep the audit certificate open until we determine the objection. I suspect one of the questions I might get would be how long it takes to determine that objection. It's a difficult question to answer, and realise it will take as long as it needs to take, and we will continue to work with you around all of that. So finally, just to sort of be clear about what I'm asking you to do and what happens next. So we're asking you to note the contents of our report, note the fact that the audit is now complete, subject to you approving the financial statements and the letter of representation. Our intention is to issue an unqualified opinion, unqualified VFM conclusion, and no other matters to report, and then we'll continue to determine the objection and obviously provide a continuing update on that in due course. So finally from me, just thanks for the continued cooperation throughout the audit. There's a lot involved in the audit.
whilst this is all going on, I want to reassure members that actually, you know, we are not concerned about them as professionals. Okay? And as the lack of letter of representation is obviously now here within your agenda, those are the only changes that I've highlighted.
Okay, so have any questions?
Mr. Chair, just a question on page 167 in relation to table page. It seems to be a big shift in the balance between audits with institutions and regulatory institutions. Is this a change of policy, or is it just an ethical aid institution to invest in?
Yeah, I think you're right. There's less triple head institutions. I mean, the Treasury management strategy is published every year as part of the budget papers. So all strategy of our is contained in Treasury management strategy.
Anybody else? Can we approve the accounts and the letter of representation? Agreed? We now go back to the minutes of the last hour of the Dortmund School Society meeting, maybe 1:15. Has anybody got any questions on that? We agree with the true record?
Yes.
Will the minutes be approved? Is that agreed? Okay. This is advised that there's been no public questions, no questions put forward, so that will fall to item 4. Having said that, page 16.3,
thanks, Chair. Chair, as you well know, the Liverpool City Council welcomes constant feedback and we take things very seriously. This year, there were 5.5 months to put forward things across both stages of the housing process. This is against the background of 1.2 million calls to our contact centre and 265,000 visits to our one-stop shops. 19.9 million invested in recycling waste collections, the move of 25,000 more properties to the managed weekly collections, and the issuing of 574,000 annual and daily council tax bills for 222,000 for the properties within the city. The council is committed to putting things right with the local government ombudsman makes the findings of maladministration and injustice. And we complied 100% with all of the ombudsman findings for this year. And Andrea is going to outline the report very briefly for us.
Thank you, Jim. I won't go through the whole report, but I'll go through some of the headline things and then I'll take the question. we'll make a long response to that. So I'll take any questions.
Any questions?
Okay, thanks, Chair. I'm looking at the three main reasons why people go on out and say one thing that I'm concerned about is that as a city, the most two important portfolios that we are looked at are children and adults, and I'm just wondering that what percentage of that. I know you've got the figures here, but in this report it says the top three complaints are recycling, taxi driver, behaviour and council tax. Now, given the way things are going with the funding and the 90 million we've got in fact, I'm wondering, are people really equipped enough to know about animal set? Because I would say now more complaints are going to be coming in with children's services and adult services. And also, it says in this report that some of them were statutory complaints. I'd like to know what your interpretation is of a statutory complaint and who determines what slot a complaint goes into.
It's a good question. Now, there are two separate pieces of legislation that cover complaints for adults and complaints for children, and they are not, they don't form the municipal set. The law is very specific, so the Children Act covers children's complaints, and there's a separate legislation which it doesn't fall within nine years. Now, that they are reported on separately. Adults and children's statutory reports go to that committee, and they don't know what it is. And the general criteria that we use is if it's about an aspect of care, then that would be dealt with under the statutory process, and it would form part of that. We'll say that.
That's fine.
That's great.
Thank you very much.
Can I just ask one question? Page 22. All government arms. Seems ready to review a single compliance, including the duty to send out within 27 days. Part of that. The review has now been completed. But how many points were included in the review to be an action? How many actions were taken? It's on page
do welcome complaints and we do want people to contact us and we try and make it as easy as possible. So that's as well as what you've read. Yeah, contact method is it's not part of this report, but I can send it. I can send that out to the databases. We do know that 54% use our online form, 11% use email, and 16% use the contact centre. So the rest were in Lexington. In answer to your second question about the LGO training course, the LGO training course for complaints officers is universally recognised as the best training course that there is. Now, we did run training courses for people who were dealing with complaints a few years ago, but because of changes to the organisation, we've now got a different set of people dealing with complaints, and we're actually in the process of procuring that course again right now.
Is that the same course as it says on the paper, 700 people trained last year, feedback shows 96%. That's so positive. Even if we're not doing the full, we'll do a very good job on them. Liam.
Downside to that is because people are increasingly contacting us online, which I knew, yeah, I'm not sure.
do acknowledge that we've had to go with that our community service has gone through a huge change in the way they were doing now the local authority training will be ongoing. So we are keeping a very, very close eye on that as that change happens to make sure that there's no increase or in complaints or there's not something that we need to look at more closely.
Okay.
Just on
page
22 of our parking.
Continuing through the year on these.
Business.
need to deliver the services. So within those strategic risks, they are highlighted. We identify the owner and the mitigation and the impact of that risk and the likelihood. So we have a regular quarterly corporate risk meeting, which is attended by a representative from each director. They have offline a number of activities that they have to manage with regard to risks. So whilst I present the high level risks to this committee, there is a lot of activity with regard to specific risks in the directorates. They present it to my corporate risk group and I summarise for this committee.
Just to help you, if I may, the thinking behind my question, this is the first time I've sat on this committee, is reporting of those individual risks up and down through the governance arrangements of the council, which I didn't expect to see in this committee as an old, as the opportunity to take quite deep dives into them. So that it's understanding how that works in reporting.
I think it'd be useful to have what you just said, that you